Now, SMS Cole, SMS Zaki, MOS Gan, and I have shared about MOM's three themes for this COS: seizing opportunities, strengthening support for you, and securing better workplaces with you. I've earlier covered the first two themes, and I will now touch on the third: how we stand in solidarity to secure safer, fairer, and more progressive workplaces with you. We are doing so in a couple of ways. MOS Gan has shared details on our efforts to support our women at work and help persons with disabilities and ex-offenders find employment. SMS Zaki has also elaborated on our efforts to ensure safety in the workplace. Now let me share about the workplace fairness legislation, which is a significant step towards ensuring a level playing field. Members will have seen the 20 interim recommendations by the Tripartite Committee on Workplace Fairness, which I co-chair with Brothers Chi Meng and also Dr. Robert Yap. Calls for legislation date back to 1998, with various parties, including Labour MPs, proposing for legislation to strengthen our efforts in tackling discrimination. Indeed, this significant move is going to strengthen our overall framework to uphold workplace fairness. Mr. Gerald Giam asked for comprehensive protection for persons with disability, while Mr. Leong Man Wai suggested to cover sexual orientation in the legislation. They both can be assured that all forms of discrimination are not tolerated. This is our national policy, and it is reflected in the Tripartite Guidelines for Fair Employment Practices today. The Tripartite Committee has recommended that the new legislation provide stronger protection against discrimination on the grounds of nationality, age, sex, race, religion, disability, and mental health conditions. Stronger protection against discrimination in the proposed areas also supports Singapore's key social and economic objectives. For instance, protecting against discrimination on the grounds of age helps to support the employment of mature workers, which is critical for our aging society. These characteristics are the common and familiar forms of workplace discrimination in Singapore. Together, they account for more than 95% of discrimination complaints received by TAFEP and MOM in the past 5 years. We have experience dealing with these cases, and we are confident to mediate them effectively. Tripartite partners will work with relevant stakeholders to ensure that there's clarity on issues such as definitions and scope of employers' responsibilities to enable the legislation to achieve its intended effect. Some MPs have raised suggestions on the legislation. Mr. Leong asked how the legislation will address job security for Singaporeans. Legislation will benefit Singaporeans by better protecting them against workplace discrimination. There will be a wider range of enforcement levers against errant employers that are more effective as deterrents against workplace discrimination. The Fair Consideration Framework job advertising requirement will also be legislated, which will allow us to take action against employers who breach this requirement using the new enforcement levers. The Tripartite Committee has also recommended protection against retaliation for those who report workplace discrimination or harassment, to give assurance to employees to come forward to report it. The majority of complaints on nationality discriminations are by locals indeed, so they will benefit from the greater protection. Mr. Leong also suggested small firms should not be exempted from the legislation. Small firms may not have the corporate competencies to comprehensively implement the new rules from day one. As the proposed legislation is only the first step, we will exempt small firms with fewer than 25 employees for a start. Workers in small firms, however, will continue to still be covered by TGFEP. Those who are unfairly dismissed can lodge claims with TADEM, the Tripartite Alliance for Dispute Management. For these employers, we will also step up education and enforcement efforts via the TGFEP. The Tripartite Committee agrees that we will monitor the ground situation after legislation is introduced and review the exemption with a view to tightening it within 5 years. Now, Mr. Leong referred to a specific case in a religious organisation in 2013. For that case, based on prevailing guidelines and laws, the church did not have sufficient grounds to dismiss the employee. With the introduction of the workplace fairness legislation, the Tripartite Committee consulted various agencies, religious organisations and advocacy groups on their views. We recognise that maintaining religious harmony is important in our multi-religious society. It is therefore important to give religious organisations the space to practice their religion. As such, given the purpose and the character of religious organisations, the Tripartite Committee has recommended allowing religious organisations the discretion to make employment decisions based on religion and their religious requirements. It must be emphasised that this discretion given to religious organisations is very carefully scoped. It will only apply to places of worship and religious organisations with sole religious purpose and function. It will also not allow them to discriminate based on other protected characteristics where there's no religious basis to do so. On the question of vaccination differentiated measures, we have reached out to and offered employment assistance to the unvaccinated workers. They can also approach WSG or E2I if they require further assistance. Workers who feel that their employers are imposing vaccination as a requirement without genuine occupational needs may approach MOM or TAFEP for assistance. Since the release of the updated advisory on COVID-19 vaccination at the workplace in October 2022, there's only been a handful of such complaints. Ms. Janet Ang and Ms. Yeo Wan Ling will also be assured to know that we will continue to engage employers, employees, HR partners and other key stakeholders to make clear the intent of the legislation and the whole of society effort required to uphold workplace fairness. During the implementation process, we will also work with NTUC to help employees to better navigate the case management process and seek remedies for their grievances. And we will work with SNEF to guide employers to adopt fair employment practices and comply with the legislation. Even as we introduce stronger worker protections in legislation, we want, and let me emphasise this, we want to preserve Singapore's harmonious and non-litigious workplace culture. To this end, the committee has also made recommendations to encourage disputes to be resolved within the firm in the first instance, and if not, through mediation to repair the employment relationship where possible, with adjudication at the courts only as a last resort. Now, we will continue to welcome all feedback, including from MPs today. The Tripartite Committee will take the feedback into consideration for its final recommendations. Now, with that, Mr. Chairman, let me now conclude in Mandarin. 这一年来，我参与了许多的对话会，大多国人都明白经济复苏正面临多项的挑战，令我欣慰的是，国人对未来仍抱有 希望，积极地分享他们的理想和抱负，这让我想起《新谣金曲》细水长流的开头。我相信我们的黄部长有唱过在卡拉 OK， 年少时候谁没有梦？想当年我刚踏入职场的时候，也一样壮志无数。但我了解个人的职业道路 未必平坦，可能坎坷，也可能需要拐几个弯才能够达到目的地。无论你是少年，或是像我一样已步入中年，我要强调的是，人力部会一直陪伴和扶持你，帮你加强就业韧性，以你向前迈进。换句话说， 无论你是出于哪一个年龄的年程，就是二十岁、三十岁、四十岁，还是年过五十，我们都会帮助你提升求职能力，续创更好的就业机会。如果你想转换工作，我们会支持你提升技能和进行再培训。如果你刚失去了工作，我们会助你一臂之力，谋求新的职位。如果你想从事手艺类型的工作，我们会提供更多的学习机会，帮助你进行职业转型。如果你已经接近退休年龄，我们会继续强化公积金制度，满足基本退休需求，让你能够安享你的晚年。所谓保健胜于治疗。 国人是否能够持续保卫把握新机遇，关键是在于个人的职业健康。我们必须为自己的职业健康负责，了解职业的需求、行业的发展趋势，以及自己的兴趣和能力。我们将在职业前程配对网站，就是 My Career Future 推出。 职业搜寻 Careers Finder 功能。这项功能将通过数据分析和人工智能，提供更个人化的职业规划和工作配对辅导。我们还需要建立一个更包容的劳动力市场。所谓行行出状元，尽管靠脑力的工作依旧受重视。 我们也不能忽略靠手艺的工作，无论是在哪一个行业，都应该有一条通往成功的道路。我们正在研究如何重新设计靠手艺的工作，通过更高的起薪、更好的技能提升机会，来吸引和留住从事这些工作的员工。 来改变社会观念必须经过一定的时间和过程，所以我们要持之以恒。我们也不断地加强国人退休后的经济保障。公积金制度是我国养老体系的主要支柱，能够满足我国退休人士基本的生活经济需求，我们必须与时并进。 着重研究如何提高年长者所能获得的每个月的利息。细水长流的尾声的结尾唱道：“人生的机遇千百种，但有知心常相种。人愿长久，水愿长流。”我希望你能把人力部视为你们。 在职业道路上的知心凉拌，给予反馈的意和意见，共同探讨和改善政策的方针。这也是我们政府推出新加坡携手前进运动的目标，以更新社会企业。我们在人力部，这整个政府会继续与你并肩同行，度过克服难关，迈向一个更美好的未来。谢谢大家。